by conducting some of the musicians of the principal bands with which he's been associated. Man of Brass.
Hello, and a good welcome to my birthday concert. With all my friends here, not all of them personal friends, because in my BBC life, I used to have to look after brass and military bands. But of course, I couldn't possibly invite all the military bands here tonight. There are too many of them. But what better playing for me than a representation from the Royal Military School of Music, Kneller Hall, where all the bandmasters are trained, and many bandsmen too. So thank you very much, Colonel Evans, and the Kneller Hall trumpeters and percussion. As usual, most band concerts start with a march. Well, we thought of hundreds of marches, but we also thought this is an opportunity to give away a secret. A march which goes around with a composer by the name of H.R. Morton, M-O-R-T-O-N. A few people have discovered it, but perhaps I'd better tell you the truth. It is me. One of my very first marches. So we'll start the program with my march, the Medallion. Now for my first soloist and a solo called Alpine Echoes, which has been very much part of my life. In fact, it was written by Basil Windsor, who again, like the man I just discovered was Morton, was really Mortimer. Basil Windsor's real name was Eli Smith. But he didn't feel that was a very good name, so he called himself Basil Windsor instead. And he wrote this particular solo, especially for my Echo Cornet. It had its first performance at a Crystal Palace concert, at the evening concert in 1926, conducted, of course, by my father, Fred, when we were both at Foden's. So I'm asking my colleague and friend, Philip McCann, the principal cornet of Black Dyke, to play for you now Alpine Echoes. Please welcome Philip McCann.
Thank you.
Thank you, Philip. Now, next comes an evergreen, The Lost Chord. I suppose it's always been considered one of the best 100 tunes, but it had its first impact on the brass band world as long ago as 1900 in the Royal Albert Hall, when the composer, Sir Arthur Sullivan, himself conducted a mass band concert, and in that program was this very tune, The Lost Chord. It was sung then by that famous Dame Clara Butt. I wasn't present, it was 2 years before my time, but it's still a well-loved tune, and this arrangement by Gordon Langford makes it even more pleasing to listen to, The Lost Chord. And what a grand sound. By the way, this assembly of musical friends have come from all